Wow, I was feeling hot. Hi there, Tilcon, New York. Welcome back for another weekly message. Hope you're all doing well. The sun's out today. And first and foremost, happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. And I'm tired of dancing. But all the moms out there, all the single moms, all the moms that work hard, all the moms that, you know, put a lot of effort and time into their children, we love you. Thank you. All right. So the song was Hot, Hot, Hot by Buster Poindexter. It was a song back in the 80s. Buster Poindexter was from the New York Dolls. So this week we're going to talk about another type of hot. As we start to warm up, and even though we might not believe it at this moment, but we're going to have hot weather at some point. So I want to talk a little bit about heat stress. With this week's presentation, or this week's video, I've also attached the PowerPoint presentation to go in a lot more depth with your employees. All right. So heat stress is dealing with the body conditions, the conditions of our body in certain situations. So for heat stress, it talks about what our surroundings are, what our level of physical activities are, what type of work are we doing, how much time are we spending during that work, and what's the recovery time that we have. So as we go through, inside of our body is like a thermometer, but they call it a thermoregulator. And that tries to maintain our body temperature approximately 98.6. Some people regulate a little bit just by the nature of their makeup, but for the most part, we try and maintain at 98.6. Now, when we increase our heat or decrease our heat, some of the things that do that is called radiation. That's why one object to another, you know, get radiating heat. That's what we're talking about. Convection, that's air moving across our skin, like a convection oven. Air moves across to heat up our food. Conduction, that's direct contact with certain objects. You're standing next to a hot oven. You're standing next to a hot piece of equipment. And then evaporation, that's when air absorbs our body moisture across our skin or through our lungs. So those are the four conditions that can change based on increased temperature or decreased temperature. So some of the minor disorders that we have. I'm a beach goer. My wife and I have loved going down to the Jersey Shore and hanging out. And we like going on summer vacations where there's usually a beach. So one thing you don't want to get is sunburn. Anybody that's had sunburn over the years know it hurts. It'll hurt for a while. So they always tell you to put on sunscreen and not tanning lotion. Now I know we all want to look good throughout the year. We want to have that nice tan throughout the year without that spray on. But please make sure that you protect yourself, whether you have a hat, but it's important to put that sunscreen on when you go out to the beach and working outside in the yard. Heat rash. My parents used to call it prickly heat. You know, you kind of get those goosebumps, if you will. So what you try to do here is you keep your skin cool and dry as best as possible. Now, as we start on the minor, we start talking a little bit on the major side, and that's heat cramps. You can get heat cramps in your arms, your legs, your stomach. Usually you get these heat cramps not while you're working, but after you start to relax. You know, you sit down, you're taking a break for a while, and all of a sudden it cramps up. We used to call it a Charlie horse, okay? You just get kind of cramped. Used to happen sometimes when I used to play baseball during the summertime. So those are the type of things that you get with regards to heat cramps. So you want to try and stay in the shade as long as possible. Loosen your clothing. You know, wear loose clothing. Drink lightly salted fluids. It all depends if you have medication issues with regards to how much salt that you should be intaking. So you should talk about that with your doctor. And then seek medical attention if the cramps persist. If you're constantly and the cramps won't go away, please seek medical attention. Some of the major heat disorders. Now with these, it's important that you always seek medical attention. Heat exhaustion. Here you'll see somebody with heavy sweating. cool and clammy skin, you know, weak pulses and fatigue. The things that you try to do here until medical attention shows up is put the person in the shade, loosen their clothing, cool the victim down as fast as possible, whether you have a fan, whether you put, you know, put cold water on them, if you have ice, you know, if you could get the person to drink water with salt if available, elevate their legs, and all time stay with the victim until medical personnel arrive. And then the last and the worst and the most fatal here is heat stroke. This is where the body is depleted of salt and water. I mean, it's just basically gone. So what ends up happening is you have to call 911 immediately. Lower the victim's body temperature as fast as possible. You know, massage the body with ice if you have to. This is death threatening. So please, by all means, make sure if somebody's fatigued, they're kind of, you know, they're kind of going limp, get them down, call 911 immediately, and, you know, try to lower their body temperature. So just a couple of control measures. Whether you're working on the job, you're working at home, outside, doing do-it-yourselfers, hydrate. You should be drinking about an 8-ounce bottle of water every 30 minutes if you're working outside. You know, look at your work-rest cycles. Maybe a half an hour of work, maybe 10 to 15 minutes of rest. You should try to maintain that. Minimize hot foods. It increases your body heat. And then have a light lunch. You know, your heaviest meal during a hot day should be at dinner time when you're cooled down. Loose fitting clothes. You know, you don't want anything tight, kind of skin grabbing. And then finally, no alcoholic beverages. And reduce your intake on caffeine. Now you're probably saying, oh dude, I can't drink any brewskis. Well, you really need to minimize that, because what it does is it dehydrates your body. So that's the heat stress part of it. Now, my friends, I want to talk about another type of stress. You know, while working from home, it has its perks. Many of you have turned their living spaces into offices are discovering that there's a stress that comes along with that. So here's a few ideas to help maybe reduce that stress. For many of us, the lines that separate work life and home life have blurred. You know, they all kind of mix together. So it's really important to maintain a structure in your life. Barring some kind of emergency situation, try to start and end your day roughly about the same time. Experts tell us that waking up at the same time and keeping a consistent schedule every day help to maintain our mental health. And that's really important for us, you know, to maintain our mental health. Secondly, get dressed. You know, we kid around about, hey, I haven't worn a pair of pants, you know, that doesn't have elastic in a long time. Well, that's true. Many of us haven't. But it's not only getting up dressed, but don't you have to get dressed up. We're not throw on a shirt and tie or a dress or anything like that. But get dressed, even if you're not planning to go out. If you are ready for your day and whatever comes along, your mindset will be ready as well. So whatever happens, you'll be free. You'll feel more up to that task. And that's important. That's important for yourself, your self-image as well. Now, even though the gyms are closed and even though the weather hasn't really been fabulous over the last few weeks, it's as important as ever for us to set aside some time to exercise. Whether you bike a trail, you know, walk a path, or just pop in some aerobic DVD. You know, make sure it's a priority to get your heart rate going. You know, it's important to get your heart rate, you know, pumping at least once a day. You'll feel better, you'll look better, and believe it or not, you will think better. So my friends in safety, this is our part of history. You know, it's a tough time for all of us, but for generations to come, they will talk about 2020 and what is going on. You know, people that were around for a while, I mean, they talk about where they were during the day that JFK was shot, the day that Martin Luther King was shot. Many of us can talk about where we were, what we were doing during 9/11. I mean, so right now is that opportunity for us, each and every one of us, to make a difference. We have the responsibility and we have that opportunity to make a difference in our homes, make a difference in our jobs, making a difference in the communities that we live in, make a difference here in New York and New Jersey, make a difference in our country, and make a difference in our world. And then, what are you going to do to make a difference? So I'm going to leave you with this. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference in the world. Thank you, Tilcon, New York. Have a safe week.